Thank you. Could you all take your seats if possible? So we're on a tight schedule today. Before we start, before we introduce our speakers, I have a little bit of housekeeping. Many of us, of course, were appalled by the attack on the offices of the French satirical magazine, Charlie Hebdo, in Paris yesterday. The club has set up a petition or a letter which is down in the corner there, which I would ask anybody who feels as appalled as we do to sign. A group of Japanese and foreign journalists will also be visiting the French embassy later today. You're invited to join them, of course, either in person or by signing the petition, whichever you prefer. If you want to join us in person, then please let me know and I'll tell you the details. Also, copies of Uemura-san's, our speaker today, copies of his two original Asahi articles are also available in the corner there. I'll set them in context in a moment. Well, our speaker today may have something to say about extremist political violence. Takeshi Uemura is a former journalist with the Asahi newspaper, and he currently teaches at Hokusei Gakuen University in Hokkaido. In 1991, he reported on the testimony of a former comfort woman in South Korea, where he was based. These articles became a lightning rod for an issue that continues to haunt ties between Japan, Korea, and other Asian countries, and it seems to have become increasingly vitriolic under the current Prime Minister, Shinzo Abe. Critics say that Mr. Uemura, and Japan's liberal flagship newspaper, the Asahi, smeared Japan's reputation abroad by spreading lies about the Imperial Army's role in World War II. They have fought to reverse an admission by a previous government of military involvement in coercing Asian women into sexual slavery. They say the women were prostitutes who willingly provided comfort to frontline troops. The comfort women issue has become a pitched battle between those who say that Japan has been singled out for its brutality in war and others who accuse it of whitewashing the past. Uemura-san has endured some personal suffering in this issue. Last year, he was forced to quit a post at Kobe Shoin Women's University, which he started after he left the Asahi. A weekly magazine triggered a tsunami of hate mail against him. His current employer in Hokkaido has also received hate mail and a bomb threat after employing him, and his family has also been targeted. He managed to save his job after supporters nationwide mobilized against what they called Japan-style McCarthyism. Now, we have Uemura-san, who's going to talk for about 20 minutes. We also have his lawyer, that's Hajime Kambara-san. We have Koichi Nakano, a well-known face here, professor of political science at Sophia University. He's going to speak for a couple of minutes. And my colleague, Teddy Jimbo, is sitting at the end there. Please also acknowledge the presence of our wonderful translator, Takamatsu-san, on whose shoulders all of the hard work here will be borne. Can I ask, please, that you give your best attention. If you haven't already switched off your mobile phone, please do so. Please, if you can, not disrupt the speaker when they're talking. That'll be very helpful. Thank you. Uemura-san, onegai shimasu.
皆様, 今日はお忙しいところ私の記者会見に来ていただきましてありがとうございます。
So thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for coming in spite of your busy schedules to attend my press conference today.
パリの新聞社襲撃事件で多数の記者たちが亡くなったこと、本当にショックを受けてます。
I find it very, very shocking that several reporters were killed yesterday in Paris.
1987年5月に私の朝日新聞での同じ同期の記者 小尻智博記者がやはり支局に襲撃されて殺されたという事件がありました。
Many of you may remember this, but in May of 1987, there was a similar incident in my own Asahi newspaper, in the Kobe office or the Hanshin office of my Asahi newspaper. A young man, a reporter who was actually my doki or my colleague, we entered the newspaper in the same year, a man named Tomohiro Koziri, he was also shot and killed.
改めてそのことを思い出して、ショック、まあ、今回の事件を本当に衝撃を受けて受け止めております。
So, partly because of my terrible memories of that period, of the events of yesterday, it was very shocking to me and brought back horrible, feelings.
同じジャーナリストとして、こうした暴力には絶対に屈してはいけないというふうに改めて思いました。
However, hearing the news yesterday, it made me realize that I must be even stronger than ever in my resolve not to ever bend down or to be crushed by violence.
私が非常勤講師として勤めています北西学園大学にも昨日また脅迫状が送られてきました。
As was mentioned earlier by the MC, I'm working as a part-time lecturer at Hokusei Gakuin University in Hokkaido, and yesterday that university received another threatening letter.
匿名の名に隠れてこうした卑劣な脅迫行為は絶対に許すことができないと思います。
I think it is quite terrible of them to disguise their identity, to send an anonymous letter of this kind, and to threaten a university. This kind of action cannot be allowed to continue.
なぜ北西学園大学に脅迫状が来るかと言いますと、私がそこに勤務しているからであります。
Of course, I think you understand why Hokusei Gakuin University is receiving these kinds of threatening letters. It is because they have employed me as a lecturer.
去年日本の週刊誌週刊文春という週刊誌の記事で私が捏造記者というふうにレッテル貼りをされました。
As many of you know, last year in the Japanese weekly magazine called Shukan Bunshu, and there was an article that basically labeled me as a reporter who fabricates stories, a fabricating reporter.
それで全く私の記事とは関係ない大学にまでこういうふうな脅迫行為が及んでいるわけです。
As a result of that article, there has been a progressive attacks directed against me, and it has become enlarged enough so that these attacks have expanded to include this university, which has nothing to do with anything I've done in the past.
私は訴訟準備のために東京にいましたんで、大学の方には行ってなかったんですが、改めて、私のためにこういうふうに大学が脅迫にさらされることに、心が痛みます。
Because I was in Tokyo for some time now, preparing for the lawsuit that I'm going to be filing. As a result, I was not at the university in Hokkaido for some time. However, when I heard the details of the threatening letters and calls, etc., that they've been receiving, my heart is filled with pain.
本日私は、週刊文春を発行する文藝春秋社及びその週刊誌にコメントを発表した東京キリスト教大学の西岡努氏の両名を名誉毀損訴訟の被告として裁判を起こしました。
Today, I did file a lawsuit charging defamation of character. In other words, I filed a libel suit and, against two parties. One is the Bungei Shunjun publisher, which publishes the weekly magazine I referred to earlier, Shukan Bunshun. I also am filing charges against a professor of Tokyo International Christian University, ICU, a man named Mr. Tsutomi.
Tokyo.Tokyo. Not international.
Excuse me. The interpreter made a terrible mistake. It's a Tokyo Christian University.
Yes. Not ICU.
Professor Tsutomi Nishioka. It is not ICU. 失礼しました。
私は私の人権、私の家族の人権、家族の友人の人権、勤務先の北西学園大学の安全を守るためにこの訴訟を起こしたのであります。
And the reason I filed this libel lawsuit is because I need to protect my human rights, the human rights of my family, my friends, and also the safety of my place of work, the Hokusei Gakuin University.
私は24年前の1991年、朝日新聞大阪社会部時代に韓国で名乗り出た朝鮮人慰安婦のおばあさんの辛い体験の記事を署名入りで2本書きました。
24 years ago in 1991, I was working in the city department or city desk of the Osaka branch of the SIU newspaper, and I wrote two articles about a woman in Korea, an older woman who had worked as what we call in Japan, Iyanfu or comfort woman during the war. And she was the first person to come forward to explain her bitter experiences, and so I wrote two articles about that.
この記事が原因で23年間ずっとバッシングを受けております。
But as a result of this, for over two decades, I've been the target of great bashing.
この記事で私がその存在を報じた方はキム・ガクジュンさん、韓国語ではキム・ハクスンさんとおっしゃる方で、韓国でカミングアウトした第一号の慰安婦でありました。
So the woman that I wrote about was a lady named in English Miss Kim Hak-sung, and she was the first lady to come forward who explained that, confessed that she had been forced to work as a comfort woman.
彼女の勇気ある証言によって、まあ、慰安婦の生の証言が世界に伝わって、そしてたくさんの慰安婦の被害者が名乗り出るようになった。
It was tremendously courageous of her to step forward and talk about her very, very difficult past. But because she did have that courage, many, many others followed in her footsteps. And so many,
そういう意味では、慰安婦問題が世界に知られるようになった、その証言者の第一号のおばあさんでした。
So she was an elderly lady even at that time, but she was the first lady who confessed, came forward and said that she had worked as an 慰安婦, which is translated into English quite often as comfort woman or sex slave.
1年前、週刊文春の2月6日号、1年前の2月6日号ですね。今からちょうど1年近く前に発売された記事にですね、その91年の、さっき皆さんのお手元にあります91年の8月の記事が、批判的に紹介されました。
I mentioned earlier that there was an article in the 週刊文春 weekly magazine last year. This was the February 6th issue of last year, and it was one that libeled me, slandered me in a very terrible way, and it focused on an article that I'd written in August of 1991. I think a copy has been distributed to you.
この見出しを見ていただけると分かりますが、慰安婦捏造、朝日新聞記者がお嬢様女子大学のお嬢様女子大学教授にというふうにあります。
As you can tell by the title, it is very, very critical. It says that this reporter who fabricates stories is going to become a professor at a university for young ladies.
西岡氏、先ほど私が訴えた西岡氏ですが、西岡氏はこの週刊誌のコメントで私の記事に対して、強制連行があったかのように記事を書いており、捏造記事と言っても過言ではないというふうにコメントされています。
There are some comments included in that article from the professor I mentioned earlier, Mr. Nishioka. He says that the article that I wrote basically gives the impression that these women were forcibly taken away. The Japanese phrase is 強制連行, forcibly taken away. And therefore, it would not be an overstatement to say that this is a fabricated story, a fabricated article.
この記事であります。皆さん見てください。この記事のですね、本文と言いますが、本文の2段落目にですね、女性の話によると、中国東北部で生まれ、17歳の時に騙されて慰安婦にされたと書いてます。
If you look at the actual article, I'm sorry, it's only in Japanese, but in the second paragraph of this article, it says, according to this woman's statement, she was living in the northeastern part of China, and when she was 17 years old, she was tricked or deceived into going to the battlefield.
しかし西岡氏はですね、私のそうした記述にはここでは触れないで、騙されて慰安婦にされたという記事には触れないで、強制連行があったかのように書いており、捏造というふうに言っております。
Of course, as I mentioned earlier, Professor Mr. Nishioka does not make any mention of that phrase that I just read to you. Instead, he again stated that the article gives the impression that the woman was forcibly taken away, this 強制連行 concept, and therefore he says that this article is basically a fabrication.
これはフェアではないと思います。
I do not think that kind of comment is fair.
私の記事はリードで女子低身体という言葉を使いました。
In my article, at the beginning of the article, I used the term 女子低身体, which is literally translated as women's volunteer corpse.
当時韓国では慰安婦のことを女子低身体あるいは低身体という言葉で表現しておりました。
The reason I use this term was that at the time in South Korea, when we talked about Yeonfu or comfort woman, they were referred to as Taeshintai, just Taeshintai, which again is women's volunteer corps.
しかし、西岡氏は91、92年の4月の4月ですね、今92年の4月の文藝春秋で、これについて重大な事実誤認というふうに批判しておりました。
However, Mr. Nishioka wrote an article in the April 1992 issue of the monthly 文藝春秋 magazine, and he said again about this article that there was a serious misunderstanding or mistaken, erroneous assumption or understanding of the facts in this article.
その当時西岡氏はですね、92年の4月の文藝春秋の記事では、朝日に限らず日本のどの新聞も金さんが連行されたプロセスを詳しく報せず、大多数の日本人は当時の日本当局が権力を使って金さんを慰安婦にしてしまったと受け止めてしまったと書いています。
At the time of this article that Mr. Nishioka wrote in April of 1992, he said that it was not just the Asahi newspaper, but actually all Japanese newspapers, none of them looked into detail into this process of how these women were taken and made into comfort women. As a result, the majority of Japanese people were left with the impression that the Japanese authorities had used force, physical force, to take away these women.
しかしその後はですね、私だけを狙い撃ちにして批判しております。98年頃から批判が捏造という言葉に変わりました。
But after this, in spite of the fact that there were other people that he was targeting at that time, after this point, Mr. Nishioka began to target only myself. And from around 1998, his terminology changed. He began to actually use the word fabrication, which the Japanese word is a 捏造。
同じ91年の記事に対して評価を変えてしまってるんです。
In regard to the article that I wrote in 1991, his evaluation or assessment of the article has changed over time.
フレームアップだと思います。
I think he's trying to frame me or he's trying to really focus attention all on this article.
そして結局その流れで、去年の2月6日の週刊、文春は私を捏造記者とレッテル貼りをしました。
So as a result of this direction that he's been taking for some years now, I think the result was what you saw in the February 6th, 2014 Shukan Bunshun article last year, where I was labeled a fabricating reporter.
これはフレームアップの延長線上だと思います。
I believe that this is just simply an extension of this line that he's been taking.
この記事が原因で、私の転職先の神戸の女子大学に嫌がらせのメール電話が多数殺到しました。
As was referred to earlier, as a result of this article, there has been great attacks made on me and also on the university where I was originally to be employed in Kobe, the Kobe Showing Women's University. They received tremendous amounts of protest mails and telephone calls.
そして、私が今勤務している北西学園大学にはさらに多くの抗議のメールや電話がかかってきます。
Numbers of emails and calls that have gone to my current employer, the Hokusei Gakuin University, is even more in number.
そうした抗議の電話の一部はインターネット上に公開されて、さらに憎悪を煽り立てています。
Not only that, but some of the very, very angry phone calls that are given are have been called in, excuse me, are also displayed on the internet. And as a result of being displayed on the internet, it has again fueled even further emotions.
標的は大学だけではありません。私の家族、娘にまで及びました。
The target is not only my university, but also my family, even my daughter.
娘の写真がインターネット上にさらされ、誹謗中傷が書き連ねています。つられています。
My daughter's photo has been displayed on the internet and has been subjected to terrible comments.
例えばこんなのがあります。こいつの父親のせいでどれだけの日本人が苦労したことか。親父が超絶反日活動で まあ、ちょっとここの文面が不明ですが、まあ、超絶反日活動で稼いだ金でという意味だと思うんですが、贅沢三昧に育ったのだろう、自殺するまで追い込むしかない。
Some of the terrible, libelous, slanderous statements that have been made about my daughter is that her father has the actions of her father have created so much suffering for untold numbers of Japanese people. Obviously, he has made a great deal of extra money participating in anti-Japanese movements. As a result of this money that he has been able to amass, this daughter has probably been able to grow up in luxury. We have no choice but to somehow drive her to commit suicide.
My partner is Korean. 父親が日本人で母親は韓国人なのであります。そうすると娘の書き込みにヘイトスピーチのような、コリアンを差別するような言葉まで出てきます。
My partner, my wife, is from South Korea. Therefore, our daughter is half Japanese, half South Korean, Korean heritage. As a result of this, you see some comments that are written on the internet about her that use very, very pejorative terms that you sometimes see in hate speeches now.
私はこうした週刊文春の捏造というレッテル貼り、そして西岡氏の言説が結果的にこうした状況を引き起こしたのではないかと思っております。
I've described to you some of the terrible things that have been happening, but I believe that this article that appeared last year in the Shukan Bunshun, the comments that have been made by Mr. Nishioka, have created the excitement or anger that has led to this kind of violent statements.
司法の場で、私は言論の場でも手記を発表して反論をしております。それだけじゃなくて法廷の場でも捏造記者でないことを認めていただこうと思ってます。
Of course, I do work in the field of free speech. As a result, I have written articles and I have spoken out to defend my honor and my name. But I'm also going to extend this by fighting in the courts as well to retrieve my good name and to prove beyond the shadow of a doubt that I am not a fabricating reporter.
私は捏造記者ではありません。不当なバッシングに屈するわけにはいかないのです。
I am not a fabricating reporter. I am not able to step back and simply bend to or be crushed by this kind of unjust bashing.
神原先生お願いします。
はい、弁護士で神原と申します。弁護団の方より若干補足させていただきます。
Hello, my name is Kambara, and I would like to talk to you a little bit about what we in the lawyer group of lawyers are doing to do this to help support this lawsuit.
上村さんの訴状は本日東京地方裁判所に提出されました。
So the lawsuit was filed by Mr. Uemura today at the Tokyo District Court.
被告は株式会社文藝春秋および東京キリスト教大学教授の西岡努さんということになります。
As I mentioned earlier, the defendants in the lawsuit are two parties. One is the corporation, Bungei Shunjun, and the other is a private individual, Mr. Tsutomu Nishioka, who is a professor at Tokyo Christian University.
裁判で上村さんは次の3つのことを求めていきます。
Mr. Uemura seeks to gain three things as a result of this lawsuit.
一つ目にインターネットからの西岡さんの論文の削除です。
One is that he wants Mr. Nishioka to remove the paper that he has written about this matter from the internet.
もう一つは謝罪広告の掲載です。
Another thing is that he wants the parties to issue an apology advertisement.
そして損害賠償として1650万円の支払いです。
And he is filing for damages of 16.5 million yen.
その根拠はこの捏造という記載が名誉毀損に基づく不法行為に該当するということになります。
The reason for the lawsuit is that because he was erroneously labeled as a fabricating reporter, he has this is a libel a lawsuit. He has been slandered maliciously.
現在170人の弁護士が代理人として上村さんの裁判を支援しております。
Again, we have a group of lawyers defending Mr. Uemura. There are 170 lawyers in the lawyers group.
他方、上村さんを攻撃している歴史修正主義者は他にもたくさんおります。
Having said this, however, there are other parties that have been attacking and libeling Mr. Uemura as well.
私たち弁護士はこれからも次々と裁判を起こし、上村さんの名誉の回復を図っていきたいと考えております。
As the representative of the lawyers group, I would like to explain here that we intend in the future to file a lawsuit after lawsuit against these parties in order that Mr. Uemura will be able to truly regain his good name and reputation.
私からは以上です。
Thank you very much.
中野先生お願いします。
Hello, Koichi Nakano from Sophia University. I don't really have much to add except to say that I'm here to stand by in representing hundreds of academics and journalists who support Hokusei University as well as Mr. Uemura to defend his rights and to his civil liberties as well as academic freedom and press freedom. I was here with Professor Yamaguchi of Hosei University 3 months ago when Mr. Uemura's job was on the line, when things looked really quite bad and I think uncertain whether Hokusei Gakuen was going to extend his employment, part-time employment. Since then, I think there have been certain positive change in that his yearly contract has been renewed, but also, of course, at the same time, the intimidation continues on. We need to stand by him and for press freedom as well as for academic freedom. And I think it is not an exaggeration to say that those of you who were with us 3 months ago and reported on a press conference and the dire situation in which Mr. Uemura was in did a great help in pushing the opinion within the university and nationwide that basically allowed Hokusei Gakuen to change its position to extend his contract. Thank you very much.
はい、中野でございます。上智大学の、教授でございます。私はあまりそんなに付け足すことがないんでございますが、ただ、私は他の、何百人、いたします学者あるいはジャーナリストの代表として、上村さんと、一緒に、この攻撃に立ち向かいたいというふうに考えております。やはりその人権を守らなきゃいけない、市民権を守らなきゃいけないと考えている多くのプレス、そしてまた学会の人たちがたくさんおるわけでございます。学者の世界の人たちがたくさんいるわけでございます。皆様のご記憶にあるかと思いますが、3ヶ月前に私は北海道の山口先生と一緒にここで記者会見をさせていただきました。当時、上村さんのその契約が更新されるかどうかというのは非常に微妙な状況だったわけでございます。北西学院大学も非常に揺れてたと思うんでございます。しかしながら、非常に英断をされたわけでございまして、もうとりあえず、1年間の契約更新ということになっているわけでございます。ここで3ヶ月前に皆さんがお集まりいただいてたくさんの記事を書いてくださったことについてお礼を申し上げたいと思います。皆様の記事、皆様のその発信力が北西学院のその考えを変えるためにも大きく役立ったと思います。ありがとうございました。
Thank you. Right, we're going to open the panel up to questions. Can I just remind you, first of all, to switch off your mobile, and when you come up, can you state the name of your organization and your own name? Can I also remind you, and I feel I need to do this because of the size of the group and the fact that it's a very emotive subject, not to make political statements, that it's a press club, it's not a place for political talk. If you have to be reminded of that, then I will. So please keep your questions short. We're very short of time as well. I see Richard's hand up and then Michael.
Richard Lloyd Parry of The Times. You referred during your remarks to your wife, who is Korean, and some of your critics have claimed that because of her nationality and the nationality of her family, you're not capable of being neutral in writing about issues such as the comfort women. How do you respond to that claim? And very quickly, a second question. Could you tell us your view of the the stance of Asahi Shimbun in the past few months. Of course, it has apologized for factual mistakes which were made, but some people have observed that since then it's been too submissive, self-critical, almost masochistic in its stance since then, rather than standing up for the virtues and achievements of what's still a great and historic newspaper. What do you think?
Thank you for your questions.
まずあの家内のことです。あの私のパートナーのことについて話したいと思います。
So the first question was about my wife. So I'd like to talk about her.
私はあのこの記事、先ほど言いました記事は91年の夏に書いた記事であります。
So the first article that I wrote was in the summer of 1991.
私はあのその前の年、1999年夏に2週間韓国に取材に行きました。
The previous year, in 1990, I spent 2 weeks.
90年ですよね。
In 1990, the previous year, I spent 2 weeks in Korea trying to do research.
それはあの当時日韓でですね注目を浴びてた慰安婦問題で、慰安婦のおばあさんたちがもしかしたら生存されてインタビューができるのではないか、取材ができるのではないかと思って行ったんです。
The reason I went to South Korea was because I had heard rumors that there were some previous or former comfort women, Yanfu, who might be willing to speak up now, and I was trying to find one to interview.
ところがもちろん当時は、そういう戦時中の辛い体験を語る方は、一人も会えませんでした。
However, at that time, when memories were still fresh, it was impossible for me to find anyone that would willingly talk about their terrible wartime experiences.
私は、慰安婦のおばあさんたちを調査している韓国低身体問題対策協議会、まあ、低体協といいますが、そこに行ったり、あるいは戦争の犠牲者たちの会、太平洋戦争犠牲者遺族会の事務所などにもしょっちゅう行きました。
As a result of my doing research, I visited two organizations quite often. One is called the 韓国低身体問題対策協議会, which directly translated would be the South Korean Women's Volunteer Corps Issue Countermeasures Council, but the official English title is Korean Council for the Women Drafted for Military Sexual Slavery by Japan. And the other organization was the Association of Pacific War Victims.
慰安婦のおばあさんたちには全くその2週間の取材で会えませんでした。
But as I said earlier, I could not meet any of the older women who were former comfort women.
でも一人の女性に出会いました。
However, I did have the opportunity to meet a particular lady.
先ほど言った太平洋戦争犠牲者遺族会、まあ、通称遺族会というんですが、そこで事務を取っている若い女性でした。
This was a young lady who was working at the second organization that I mentioned, the Association of Pacific Wartime Pacific War Victims. I would just call this the Victims Association. She was doing some clerical work for this association.
その女性は後で分かったんですが、韓国ではあの母親と娘のファミリーネームが違うので、後で分かったんですが、その遺族会の幹部の娘さんでした。
I learned later that she was actually the daughter of one of the executives of this Pacific War Victims Association. The reason I didn't know this at the beginning was because in Korea, the surname, the family name, excuse me, of mothers and daughters are different.
その女性と恋に陥り、結婚しました。
But I fell in love with this young lady and we decided to marry.
91年の夏にこの慰安婦のおばあさんを韓国の市民団体が調査しているという記事を書きました。
And again, I repeat, this is in 1981 summer when I wrote this article, and this article was about the result of a civic organization in South Korea who had done research on comfort women and had been able to get the testimony of a former comfort woman.
私を批判する人はですね、この記事をつまりこの記事が一番最初に慰安婦のカミングアウトの前の慰安婦の存在を明らかにした記事だったんです。それで批判してるんですね。私の妻の母親の情報によって記事を書いたんだというふうに私を批判しています。
The reason that this article, which I wrote in the summer of 1991, is coming under such a vicious attack is that it was the first article that focused on this woman's testimony, the first covered woman who had given testimony before she officially came out. And the critics criticized me, as was mentioned earlier, because of the relationship, the possible relationship I have with my mother-in-law.
そしてこの団体はですね、私のパートナーの母親の団体と違う団体なんです。
However, I would like to make clear, I know it's a little confusing, about my mother-in-law's organization and the civic organization, the private organization that got the testimony of this first comfort woman who confessed to being a comfort woman. They're two separate organizations.
そしてこの私の義母は、このおばあさんの存在を私の記事の後に知ったといいますか、出会ったわけです。このおばあさんとは。
In regard to the lady who was featured in this article that I wrote, my mother-in-law did not know about her or meet her until after I wrote this article.
当時のソウル支局長の情報で書いたわけで、親族関係を利用して書いたわけではありません。
What I'm saying is that I was able to get this story as a result of some information that was sent to me by the head of the Seoul office of the Asahi Shimbun at that time, Asahi newspaper at that time. I did not get the material for this story from any relatives or any private connections.
Asahi Shimbun の8月の検証記事でも、そして先日発表された12月の第三者委員会の報告でも、遠赤関係を書いて、利用して記事を書いた、もうそういうふうな疑惑は全く否定しております。
As you know, the Asahi newspaper issued a series of articles in August of last year where they verified and investigated for previous articles. Also, there was a report that was issued by a third-party investigating committee in December of last year. Both the Asahi newspaper and the third-party committee verified that this article was not based on any kind of personal relation connections. In other words, the doubts that had been expressed until now about my using, my having some kind of ulterior motive because of personal connections was unjustified.
私は先ほど言いましたように、私のパートナーと出会う前から慰安婦問題を取材しております。
As I explained earlier, even before I met the lady who was to eventually become my partner, I was already interested in the 慰安婦 or comfort woman issue, and I'd already been doing a lot of research on it.
これはファミリーアフェア、家族の問題として取材しているわけではないんですよ。
In other words, this has been a theme that has been very important for me. As a reporter, it was something that I was interested in before I had any personal connections in this area.
女性の人権問題として取材しているわけです。
In other words, I believe that this was an important topic having to do with women's human rights.
だから結婚しようが結婚しまいが、取材は続けたと思います。
I think whether or not I married the woman that eventually became my partner, whether I married her or didn't marry her, would have had nothing to do with the rest of my career. In other words, I would have continued to pursue this as an important topic.
続いて朝日のスタンスについてどう思うかということに答えたいと思います。
And the second question is about what do I think about the stance of the Asahi over the past few months?
朝日新聞はこの私の日本の記事とは別に吉田政治証言問題というのを抱えていました。
As many of you may know, the Asahi newspaper had two issues that they were dealing with, the two articles that I had written in 1991, and then also a series of articles that had to do with a man named Seiji Yoshida.
この吉田政治という人は、まあ、韓国最終党で女性を慰安婦にするために人狩り、まあ、強制的に連行したという証言をして、いろんな新聞、朝日新聞だけじゃなくて、さまざまな新聞に記事が出た人です。
The man named Seiji Yoshida was a person who claimed to have taken part in the rounding up of women and forcibly rounding up women, hurting women to become comfort women on the island of Jeju in Korea. And his comments were presented not only in my former newspaper, Asahi newspaper, but many, many other newspapers as well.
8月の朝日新聞の特集紙面で、私の記事については捏造がないというふうに明快に発表しました。しかし、吉田政治さんの証言は取り消しました。
As you know, in the articles that the SRI published in August of last year, in regard to the articles that I had written, they said that there was very clear that there had been no fabrication involved in the writing of my articles. However, in regard to the other articles which had to do with Seiji Yoshida, they retracted all of those articles.
その時にその取り消した時に謝罪がなかったということで大きなバッシングを受けたわけです。
And as I'm sure you all know, when they retracted these articles, they simply retracted the articles, but they did not really offer an apology, and as a result, they were bashed considerably.
まあ私もそう思います。
And I understand why that they were bashed.
だけれども謝罪はして取り消したわけですね。遅くなったけれども取り消した。
But they eventually did apologize, and they did retract these articles.
ところがその朝日新聞はつまり私が今非常にバッシングをされて家族までバッシングされる状態になっている。
But in regard to this newspaper, I've mentioned earlier that I myself have been subjected to a great deal of bashing, and my family has also been subjected to bashing.
それで非常に思うんですが萎縮していると思います。
As a result, I think the Asahi newspaper, which has been subjected to a great deal of bashing, I understand their situation because I'm the recipient of that kind of attacks as well. I think as a result, they've become very, very small. They've kind of shrunk in words because of under this assault.
私は捏造記者ではありません。それはこれから証明していきますし、今まで書いた文藝春秋今月1月号の記事などでも書いておりますその証明を。
As I have explained earlier, I am not a fabricating reporter, and I intend to keep on proving that I have not fabricated anything. I am beginning to write different articles. I've written an article in the Bungei Shunjin Monthly Magazine for the January issue that is out just now.
私に対する、バッシングの理由は、私が朝日新聞記者であること、私が慰安婦のおばあさんの記事を最初に書いたこと、そして私の家内が韓国人であること。そうしたことだと思います。
I think the reason that of all the different articles and different reporters that have written similar contents, the reason that I have been singled out for particularly severe bashing is that first of all, I was a reporter for the Asahi newspaper, and secondly, I was the first person to write an article about the coming out of a former comfort woman, and thirdly, because my wife is of South Korean ancestry.
私を攻撃して萎縮させ、そして私の出身母体である朝日新聞を萎縮させたいと考えている人々がいるんじゃないでしょうか。
I think that there are many people out there who unfortunately think that it would be a good idea to keep on attacking me and forcing me to try to bend down or to try to shrink into myself and to do the same thing with the SI newspaper as well.
もう謝罪して取り消したわけですし、今は改めて朝日新聞には元気を出して取材慰安婦問題に取り組んでいただきたいと思います。慰安婦問題が解決しているわけではないので。
I think that now that the Asahi newspaper has retracted these problematic articles, and now that it has actually apologized, I think it is time for it to get back on its feet and be more spirited and revitalized, have more energy and tackle straight on this very difficult problem of the comfort woman issue, because the comfort woman issue still has not been resolved.
Thank you. Next question, I see Michael's hand up. Can I remind you, it's just a working press from now.
Michael Penn of the Shingetsu News Agency. The criticism which has been directed against the Asahi and its comfort women coverage more generally has come not just from private sources, but also from the chief cabinet secretary and from the prime minister himself. And even after the threats of violence have been made against you and your family, these high-level, top-level criticism has continued against the Asahi Shimbun. I wanted to ask you what you think about that.And I also want to ask you what you think about the statement that the Prime Minister made yesterday, which I have here. Genran no jiu, tohoro no jiu ni taisuru tero de ari. Danjite, yurusu koto wa dekinai. So the Prime Minister made a statement in regard to what was happening in France yesterday. Do you think that he can apply those principles to Japan as well?
これまでも北星学園に 対する脅迫、嫌がらせ問題について、文部科学大臣が、それを批判する発言をされたりしております、皆さんそういう気持ちを持っておられると思いますので、ぜひそういうことで、北星学園大学を首相にも支えていただければと思っています。
Until now, in regard to the threatening or otherwise very nasty mails and calls that have been given to my employer, the Hokusei Gakuin University, even the Minister of Education has spoken out and said that this is not a good thing and we must protect the university. I would hope that eventually the Prime Minister would make a similar statement and take actions to support in the safety of Hokusei Gakuin.
Thank you. Short but sweet. Gerhard, did I show your hand up? Thank you.
Gebhard Hilscher, freelance from Germany. I want to pursue the Asahi issue because I don't know the details of the suit you have filed regarding the Asahi. Did they actually force you to resign, or what is the background of the case against your personal background against the Asahi? Did they or did you resign because of all the criticism? Was that your own decision or was it their decision? How was the background there? And if it was their decision, do you plan to also request a reinstallation in your previous Asahi Shimbun position or not? That would be interesting. The reason why I don't know some of these details, I'm already 79 and not an active journalist anymore, but I'm a freelancer, so I haven't invested that particular part. I'm sorry for that. But I still would.
There may be some misunderstanding. No, Asahi is not the defendant in the court case. Yes, so he resigned.
So you resigned, well, that's the answer.
Right. Last year in March.
Then I would ask the question, do you ever considered asking them to re-employ you because you felt unfairly no help from your employer when you were being criticized? That is the point I actually wonder, because I didn't know the details, I couldn't formulate it first. Thank you.
So I'd like to clarify first, I was not forced by the Asahi to quit my job.
先ほど言いましたように、私は当時、今56歳です。1958年4月生まれであります。
Right now I'm 56 years old. I was born in 1958, April.
だからあと4年ぐらいは働ける権利はあるわけなんですが。
Of course, I had the legal right to stay for another 4 years if I wanted.
ただ私は50歳を過ぎてから、勉強するのが好きになりました。
But after 50 years of age, I decided I wanted to start studying again.
で、大学の博士課程の後期課程に入りまして、博士論文にも取り組んでおります。
Actually, I entered a doctoral program, and I'm actually in the middle of finishing up this doctoral program.
それから2012年から北星学園、札幌の北星学園では非常勤講師をやっております。
And the university where I am currently working as a part-time lecturer or adjunct lecturer, the Hokusei Gakuin University in Sapporo, I started working there in 2012.
教えているのは国際交流講義といいまして、アジアの留学生たちに日本の社会事情、文化を教えてます。
What I'm teaching is basically foreign students, mostly students from Asian countries. I'm teaching them about Japanese society and culture.
学生時代は勉強嫌いだったんですが、年取ってから勉強が好きなことに気づきました。
It's a very strange thing. When I was a young person, I hated to study. When I was a student, I hated to study. But after I grew older, I really became interested in studying.
そしてアジアの学生たちと交流するのがとても楽しかったです。
And it's so enjoyable to be able to have these exchanges with these Asian students.
それを私がソウル特派員、北京特派員、中東特派員を体験して、アジアとの関わりの大切さというのを知ったからであります。
And I think part of that is because of my previous career. I servedas the head of the Seoul office, the Beijing office, and also I worked in the Middle East office. As a result, I began to understand how deeply important our relations with other Asian countries are.
それで大学教員に転身しようと思いまして、いくつかの大学の応募、これ公開 公募というんですが、公募に応募して北西があの神戸の大学に採用が決まったわけです。
As a result, I decided that I wanted to start the second part of my life as a university lecturer or professor, and so I visited, applied to different universities. As quite often they ask for submissions from the general public for new lecturers or professors, and I was happily accepted by this Kobe Shoin Women's University.
まあ、しかし抗議のメール等で神戸松陰は非常にあのショックを受けてですね、事実上私に辞退を求めたわけであります。
But as a result of the kind of terrible threatening and nasty mails and telephone calls that were directed toward Kobe Shoin Women's University, they were quite shocked. And but the de facto conclusion of this is that I was asked to decline the post.
まあ、それは示談という形で合意で契約を解消しました。
So, I'd already contracted to teach for them. However, we decided to settle out of court, reach an amicable settlement or arrangement.
もちろん、その時に朝日新聞をその後でやめましたから戻る方法もあったかもしれません。
Of course, I suppose there might have been a way for me to return to the 朝日新聞, my former post, at that time when this happened.
だけれども捏造記者というレッテルはもう貼られたままです。
But as I mentioned, I already had been labeled with this terrible, this stigma of being a fabricated reporter, fabricating reporter.
そのレッテルを剥がすため、レッテルを貼ったものと戦うためには、朝日に戻らず、一人のジャーナリストとして戦おうと思いました。
However, I felt that for me to be able to remove this terribly offensive label of being a reporter who fabricates stories, I felt that it would be better not to fight this battle by returning to the Asahi, but to fight as an individual independent journalist.
なぜなら、戦うためにはたくさんの時間がいるんです。
Why did I make that decision? That is because this, I knew this was going to be an enormous fight, and to have an enormous fight, you have to have lots of time.
この捏造記者というふうに記事を書かれてから、私は捏造記者でないという証拠を探すために毎日とてもたくさんの時間を使ってきました。
In other words, for me to remove this very offensive label of being a reporter who fabricates stories, I had to find proof, that evidence, that I had not fabricated stories. So I had to look for this proof, and that is a very time-consuming process.
そして、私を取材するいろんなメディアはたくさんの質問状を送りつけてきます。
And because I am very much in the public eye, many, many media come to me and give me lists of questions to answer.
時間がたくさんかかるんです。
And to be able to respond to these questions, it takes a great deal of time again.
まあ残念ですが、フリーになって時間があるので、それができるというのが今の現状であります。
So I guess in a sense, I'm a little bit fortunate because I do have time enough now to be able to respond to do all of this work that I must do.
Thank you, Anthony, and then Elaine. And I think I saw Egawa-san's hand first. Egawa-san?
Anthony Rowley, Singapore Business Times. A very quick question. Forgive my ignorance of the law in Japan, but is there such a thing as criminal libel in Japan, or are libel actions and slander actions simply civil actions? And do you think that the law in Japan needs to be tightened up to cover protection against libel and slander?
日本でも、名誉毀損罪という形で当然刑事罰はあります。で今回訴えているのは、これは 民事での訴訟ということになります。
Yes, slander or libel, malicious slandering or libel, is a criminal offense and can be prosecuted as such. The lawsuit that we filed at present is a private suit, civil suit.
Okay.
すみません、もうちょっと法律が、もっと強化されるべきだと思いますでしょうか。
Yes, that was the question, yeah.
はい、もっと強化されるべきだと思いますでしょうか。
名誉毀損罪についてという意味ですかね。
In regard to the libel laws or slander laws?
あの言論の自由というものもありますので、あの今現在、名誉毀損罪が、緩すぎると、だからもっと強化すべきだというふうには、あ、これはあの私個人の意見ですが考えておりません。
This is a personal opinion, but you have to remember the reverse side of strengthening these kind of libel or slander suits, which is that you might encroach upon the freedom of speech rights. So I believe, again, this is a personal opinion, I believe that the current slander or libel laws are appropriate.
Thank you.
Or they're not too loose.
Elaine? Yep. And can I ask you to keep your questions as brief as you can from now on? We're into extra time, to use a football analogy.
Isabel Reynolds from Bloomberg. Just going back to what Michael asked earlier, you didn't quite answer one of his questions. Do you think you could draw any parallels, although fortunately you haven't been harmed physically, between what happened in Paris and what has happened to you?And secondly, could you say anything about what effect this has had on your family? You mentioned how they've been victimized on the internet. I imagine they must be quite upset.
まあ私はあの今のところ言葉で脅されてるだけです。
At present, my situation is different from the Paris situation in that so far I've only been threatened verbally.
Paris の事件は本当に痛ましい事件です。
What happened in Paris, I think, was something that really pains the heart.
何らかの憎悪が原因で起きたと思います。
I think there was tremendous hatred lurking underneath to cause that kind of violence.
やはり寛容さが欠けている人々がこういうふうなことを起こしたんじゃないかと思ってます。
I believe people who lack a tolerant heart are the kind of people who create, who do these kinds of attacks on other people.
まあ私は今物理的な攻撃を受けているわけではありません。
As you mentioned, I've not been subjected to physical attacks so far.
ただ私の記事が捏造というふうに言われますが、当時は同じようなスタイルの記事が他の新聞にもたくさんあったんです。
But I will repeat again, I have been labeled this reporter of fabrications. However, as I will repeat again, at the time that I was writing these articles, there were many other articles, many other reporters who were writing similar things.
それが今こういうふうな形でターゲットになって、個人が標的になってバッシングされている。
However, now I am the sole target, apparently, of all of this bashing, and I, as an individual, have been subjected to tremendous pain.
やはり寛容でない社会に起きている現象という点では共通点があるかも分かりません。
So certainly what happened in Paris and what is happening to me are very, very different. But I think they have their roots in the same idea. In other words, societies are less tolerant of other people, people with different ideas and thinking than others.
歴史の暗部、まあ日本で言えば戦争中の触れられたくない過去。それに対して目を向けようという人たちに対して、まあ、あのそれをひるませようという動きが日本にあると思います。
In regard to the darker parts of history, what I'm speaking about, of course, is the very terrible part, things that happened during the war years. There are people in society who do not want to look too hard at what happened during that time. And when some people try to bring light to these facts of the past, there are people who stand up and try to prevent them from doing so.
それが誰なのか分かりません。
I do not know who these particular people People are who try are trying to prevent me.
例えば私の家に嫌がらせ電話がかかってきました。
For example, I have received very, very unpleasant phone calls in my home.
私の家の電話は全く公開していません。
I have not made my home telephone number public.
だけれども、後で調べたらインターネットに私の電話とか家の場所、娘の学校の名前。そういうものが出ていました。
However, when I did an internet search, I was able to find not only my home phone number, but my home address, also the name of my daughter's school.
弁護士にお願いして、誰が書いたか発信先を突き止める作業を何日もかけてやりました。
I asked my lawyers to look into this issue to find out who had uploaded such private information. It took many, many days.
しかし、わかりませんでした。
In spite of their efforts, however, we were not able to track down the person who finally first uploaded such information.
こういうふうな匿名性に隠れて、避難する、 人々がどんどん増えていると思います。
I think it's a very unfortunate thing, but I think the numbers of people who hide under this veil of anonymity that the internet, etc. provides, I think their numbers are unfortunately growing.
それが、私の記事とは全く関係のない私の勤務先にもこれだけたくさんの攻撃がかかっています。
It is this trend, I think, that has led to so many spiteful calls and mails being sent to my current university, which has nothing to do with the articles that I wrote in 1991.
日本は民主主義の社会のはずです。
Japan is supposed to be a democratic society.
こういうふうな卑劣な行為は絶対に許さない。
We cannot allow, we cannot tolerate this kind of terrible actions to continue.
皆さんのお力を借りたいと思っています。
But I cannot do it alone. I ask for your kind support.
Thank you. 江川さんお願いします。And then Joel.
フリーランスの江川です。よろしくお願いします。私が伺いたいのは、上村さんへの批判にですね、反日というレッテルも貼られるわけですけれども、こういった慰安婦問題などを書いた反日記者である、あるいはそういう書くことによって日本を貶めているというようなことも随分言われています。こうしたその過去の問題について書くときにですね、日本について上村さんはどのように考えていらっしゃるのでしょうか。あるいはその最近台頭しているこのいわゆるナショナリズムというものがですね、こういったその攻撃に関係しているとお思いでしょうか。その辺についてお聞かせください。
Some of the criticisms that is, that is directed toward you label you as being anti-Japanese or anti-Japan, and that many of your actions are trying to somehow lower the level of Japan on the international stage. How do you react to this? And do you think that the attacks that are being directed towards you are in any way related to the sense of growing nationalism that we're seeing in this country recently?
今ちょうど関連する資料をお見せします。
I would like to show you a document that is related to your question.
ここにですね、私宛てのハガキが、大学の着付け、大学の住所で送られてきました。読んでみましょう。出て行けこの学校から、出て行け日本から、売国奴とあります。これは大学に送りつけられたハガキであります。
This is a postcard that was sent to me in care of the university. In other words, it's addressed to the university, but sent to me. And I will read it out loud. It basically says, get out of this school, get out of Japan, you traitor.
こういうのもあります。日本で金を稼ぐな。大好きな韓国に帰化して、州都に食べさせてもらえ。
Another one says, get out of Japan because stop making money in Japan. Go instead to South Korea, which you obviously love, and let your mother-in-law feed you.
しかし私は反日ではないんです。
But I am not against Japan.
私は日本が誇り、日本が他のアジアから尊敬される本当の仲間だと思われる国になってほしいんです。
What I hope for Japan is that it will become a country that is truly considered a colleague by other Asian nations, a nation that will be admired and respected by other Asian nations.
そういう意味では私は自分で愛国者だと思っております。
So in that sense, I believe that I'm a patriot. I love my country.
学生に言ってます。僕の学生は韓国、台湾、中国から来る学生が多いです。
I say this to my students. Many of my students come from South Korea, Taiwan, and China.
いつも言ってるんですが、もちろん日本で今不愉快なことがたくさんあるかもわかんないけど、日本もいいところあるし、やはり日本と隣国は大切な関係なんで、ぜひ日本でいろんなことを学んでほしい。
I say to them that during your time in Japan, you might see some really unpleasant things, but please remember that there are many, many wonderful, good aspects of Japan as well. And please also remember that Japan and its neighboring countries, the relationship, the friendship, the ties between these countries are very, very important.
私は幸いなことに、ソウル特派員と北京特派員という二つのアジアの街の特派員をさせていただきました。
I have been very, very fortunate in my career. I was able to be a foreign correspondent based in Beijing and also based in Seoul.
人々、その時の政治状況で国と国との関係は良くなかったり、ありますが、どの街も人間としては同じように、 私は触れ合えて本当にいい隣国の人たちと仲良くなりました。
Of course, depending on the political situation of that time, sometimes the situation, the friends, the relationship between nations, between governments, may not always have been good. But regardless of what the situation was between nations or governments, I always felt as I walked through the cities of both Beijing and Seoul, all of these different Asian cities, that the people-to-people relationship was always very, very good. In other words, we always have good relationships between our neighboring countries. Japan.
そういうふうな教あの学生と接しているわけです。僕はあのアジアの中で、隣国との関係がとても大切だと思っています。それをずっと記者としてもこの記者の間あの考えてきましたし訴えてきました。
This is the kind of thing that I keep saying repeatedly to my students that the relationship between Japan and our neighboring countries are very important. This is something that I felt and believed from the bottom of my heart during my years as a journalist as well.
全く知らなかったんですが、あの僕の学生が日本語スピーチコンテストでスピーチをしてくれました。上村先生を辞めさせないでくれと。
I recently learned this. I didn't know that this student had been planning to do this, but one of my students took part in a Japanese speech contest, and the theme of his speech was, "Please don't allow Professor Uemura to lose his job."
日本に言論の自由とか学問の自由がなくなっていったら、それは隣国にも影響がある。
If freedom of speech, freedom of the academic world is curtailed in Japan, I think that will have a negative effect on neighboring countries as well.
そんな学生もって僕は幸せでしたんで、絶対にこんな卑劣な脅迫で大学を去りたくないと思ってました。
I believe that I've been blessed by having such wonderful students, and I do not want to be able, I do not want to bend or be crushed by these terrible, nasty attacks that are being made. I don't want to leave these students or my university.
こういう卑劣な書き込みとか攻撃する人たちのことを、なぜそういうふうなことをするのか。わかりません。ただ一つだけ言えるのは、多分そういう人たちは韓国や中国の人と友達がいないんじゃないかな。そういう人たちと触れ合ったことがないんじゃないかな。ただ頭の中で排外主義、ナショナリズムが高まってんじゃないかなというふうに思ってます。
In regard to these people who make these vicious, nasty, mean attacks, make these terrible comments on the internet, why do they do that? I really do not know. But I think that one reason is that these people have never had a friend from South Korea or from China. They have never had an opportunity to meet with people from these nations. So they only have a kind of ambiguous abstract concept about these people.
OK、上村さん、もう一つの質問大丈夫ですか？
あともう一つ。
あ、430。OK、Joel。
ああ、はいはい。もちろんいいです。大丈夫です。
変な日本語で申し訳ございません。Joel。Yep。If you're at the back of the room and I can't see you and you're trying to ask a question, can you put your hand up really high? I see this gentleman here. OK。
My name is Joël Legendre. I'm from the RTL France broadcasting. Thank you for all your words at the beginning of this press conference. And precisely, it's all about intimidation. And Professor Nakano, I'm going to ask you the question because I see that Mr. Uemura and the lawyer are crying. So I'm going to turn to you and ask you, is this country ready for facing such threats? I remember early this year, the emperor made an important message and...It was analyzed by some people like a criticism of what could happen in the course of political events in this country led by Mr. Abe. So is this country heading towards an extreme right side of society, or is the society able to resist to that? Well, what is this future that we have here in this country facing intimidation cases when you disagree with people?
Well, thank you for your question, Joel. Well, I don't want to be overly pessimistic, and I don't want to be a fatalist either, but I see your point. I think on the comfort women issue in particular, and the attack on Asahi as part of the story, I think there is no doubt that there is certain elements in the society that are getting emboldened because they see that they feel like they are being blessed by people at the top of the government. I think that's the challenge we have today, essentially. The civil society, I think, is very vibrant. And as we have shown, this time in solidarity with the international attention, I think we were able to fight back in this particular case of the Mr. Uemura's job at Hokusei Gakuen. And I think there are other positive stories as well. The fundamental issue here, I think, as a political scientist, it's of course my personal opinion, the political system in Japan today is grossly lacking in balance in a way that has never been the case in the post-war period. You have one-party dominance without any real opposition party to speak of. So I think that's really the background under which I think it's easy for the bullies to intimidate people and for the more moderate, if not liberal, news organizations also to feel intimidated more easily because they feel like the current government is the only game in town and it's going to stay on for a long, long time to come. I think with that background of the political condition, I think there's a huge challenge for the society to show, how much embedded, I think, the postal values of basic rights, civil liberties, and democracy are in Japan. Thank you.
Thank you. Gerhard, I see your hand, but just in case there's anybody I'm missing, does anybody else have their hand over on this side of the room? Anybody want to ask a question? This gentleman here? Yes? You gentleman with glasses? Yep. Yeah. Could you come to the mic? Thank you.
Thank you very much. 韓国連合ニュースの張と申します。実は昨年ですね、昨年11月、先生が勤めている大学校に、脅迫電話をかけて、逮捕された人が、いたと思います。その人は、逮捕されましたけど略式起訴されて、私の米から見るとそういう処分が本当に軽すぎましたと思いますけど、この事件に対しての、検察の処分とこの政府の、先生が勤めている学校に対しての、姿勢はどうだと思いますか。ありがとうございます。
I'm from, South Korea News Agency. Last year in November, I believe that there was a threatening call made to your university, and the man who made that threatening call was actually arrested. However, he was only given a summary indictment. And from my point of view, that seems to be a very, very light punishment for the thing that he did. So what do you think about the way that the prosecutor's office handled this case, and what do you think about the stance of your school in this case?
確か新潟県の男の人が逮捕されたと思います。
I believe the man who was arrested was a man from Niigata Prefecture.
全く面識のない人であります。名前も私は存じ上げませんでした。
It was a person that I had no contact with previously. I did not even know his name.
一つ私はジャーナリストとして残念なのは、なぜこの人が全く見知らぬ私のことで大学を脅迫したのか。その後のフォローの記事が日本のジャーナリズムにないことです。
One thing that disappoints me and saddens me as a journalist is that when this event occurred, there was no follow-up articles in the media about this issue. In other words, no one did any investigative reporting to try to find out why this man who had nothing to, no personal connection with me, basically attacked a total stranger myself by threatening my university. Why did he do that? There was no investigative journalism that followed.
逮捕された時は大きく出て処分、略式起訴、罰金刑なんですが、だんだんこう小さくなりました。
Of course, when he was arrested, that was a big article, and then there was a smaller article when the summary indictment was announced, and then when he was actually had to give the amount that he had to pay as reparations, as a penalty, was announced, that article was even smaller. In other words, the news kept getting smaller and smaller and smaller.
事件で一番大事なのは動機であります。
But in any case, in any incident, the most important aspect of the story is the motive.
この人がどういう動機でこういうふうなことをしたのか、その解明こそがこうした行為を防止する方法ではないかと思うんです。
The reason is that unless you understand the motive of this gentleman, unless you understand why he was doing the things that he was doing, you're not able to develop solutions to counteract or prevent similar things from happening in the future.
この処分が重かったかどうかは私は分かりません。ただ抑止効果にはなったと思います。
Whether the punishment was heavy or light, I really cannot comment. I really do not know. However, I think it had a deterring effect on other people who might think about doing something similar.
北星学園というのは学生数がたった4200人の小さな学校です。
For those of you who do not know, my university, 北星学園 University, is a very small university, a student body of only about 4200 people.
しかし明治時代にアメリカの宣教師が作ったミッションスクールであります。
However, it was established during the Meiji period, late 1800s, early 1900s, by a Christian missionary.
1995年の戦後50年の時に北星平和宣言というのを発表した学校でもあります。
It is also an unusual school because in 1995, on the 50th anniversary of the end of World War II, it made a Hokusei Gakuen peace declaration.
アジアへの侵略戦争の反対と、そして人権教育の大切さを訴えています。
It is a university that speaks out against the war of aggression that was conducted by Japan in Asia during the past previous war. It is also a university that devotes itself to teaching its students about the importance of human rights.
こんな小さな大学がこの激しい攻撃に耐えて私を雇い続けると学問の自由を守ると言ったわけです。
This is a very small university, however, it has been able to endure and fight back against the terrible onslaught of attacks that it has been experiencing over the past months, and it has made the brave decision to continue to hire me.
小さな大学が大きな勇気を示したんです。
In other words, it's a small university, but it displayed a huge, tremendous courage.
北星学園のこうした平和宣言というのは、日本政府が歩む道でもあると思います。日本政府が歩む道でもあると思います。
This peace declaration that was issued by his Hokusei Gakuen, I think that is a path that should be followed by the Japanese government.
必ずや政府も北星学園を支援して、こうした卑劣な行為を食い止める力になってくださると思います。
I believe it is only a matter of time before the Japanese government steps up to provide support to this very small university and take steps to ensure that it is protected from these terrible, mean and nasty attacks.
一言いいですか、今の件。弁護士の神原ですが、今の件で一言だけ申し上げます。
I'd like to add one comment quickly.
札幌の現地の弁護士からですね、現地の警察はこの凶悪問題に関して必ずしも熱心でないというような情報をもらっております。
捜査にですね、はい、I have spoken with some local lawyers in Sapporo, and they have talked with the local police in Sapporo, and the general impression that we receive is that the police officials or prosecutors officials are not terribly eager to pursue this case.
そこで弁護士が300人以上名前を並べて刑事告発をすると、そのような運動もやっております。
As a result, some 300 lawyers have listed their names and proposed the idea of fighting a criminal suit against this individual.
日本の警察はきちんとこのような卑劣な犯罪を取り締まるために戦うべきだということも、ここで訴えさせていただきたいと思います。
In other words, I wanted to add this extra comment because I believe it is very, very important for the Japanese police to stand up against this kind of bitter, vicious kinds of attacks. They must be willing to fight to protect their citizens.
以上です。
Thank you.
Thank you. I saw this one gentleman here, and I think that'll be the last question. Gentleman with the last is in the middle. Sorry, Gareth.
フリーランスの小林と申します。今日の会見はですね、もっぱら上村さんの被害者の立場が非常に強調されたわけです。でまあ、本当にけしからんことだと思っておりますけれども、一方でですね、吉田発言についてですね、 上村さんはちょっと私記憶にないんですが何本記事を書かれたんでしょうか。それでですね、これでこれが虚偽だということを朝日新聞は表明されたわけですが、これについてですね、この問題について、これは先ほどからどなたかの質問もありましたけれども、この吉田発言がですね、証言というのが、非常に反日機運を煽ったわけですね。でこれについて、上村さんはどういうふうに今思っていらっしゃいますか。
I'm a freelancer. In regard to today's press conference, I understand that the people at the main table are representing the victims of attacks and assaults, and I understand that, and I certainly think that what you have been subjected to is really unforgivable. But at the same time, the Asahi newspaper published many, many articles about Mr. Yoshida, or quoted him in many ways, and they said they have retracted the articles. But I believe that, and I think many people believe that, it's his comments that appeared in many media, including the Asahi newspaper, that has incited the flames of anti-Japanese sentiment. So what do you think about these articles?
の記事ありますね。私は一本も書いておりません。
I mentioned this earlier as well, but I would like to again to make this very, very clear. In regard to articles about confessions or statements made by Seiji Yoshida, I have not written a single article.
私は吉田政治証言の後にですね、慰安婦問題の取材を始めたわけであります。
であります。
吉田政治証言のの取材はしてなくて、その後に慰安婦のおばあさんに直接取材を始めた世代であります。
So, I belong to a younger generation. I never wrote an article about Seiji Yoshida, but I started writing articles about Ianfu or comfort women after his comments had been public. In other words, I started my writing about this woman who had given testimony.
本屋さんに売ってる本に朝日バッシングの本があるんですけれども、そういう中にも吉田証言をたくさん書いた上村記者というような表現があります。
I know that if you go to a bookstore you can find many books that bash or attacked the Asahi newspaper. There are some books that say that I, 上村、have written many articles about Seiji Yoshida or have quoted him.
だいたいこういうのこそ捏造というふうに言うんじゃないかなと思っております。
This is where I think the word fabrication truly comes into play, though, because that is not true.
今月号、昨日発売された世界にその辺のことを書いております。いかにデマ情報が活字にまでなっているのかというのが出ています。
Actually, I've written an article about this, which is in this month's magazine called Sekai. It just went on sale yesterday. I think it is a very, very serious thing that these kinds of rumors, which are not based on fact or which are absolutely not factually true, have now begun to appear in print.
私が書いたキム・ガクジュンさんの記事っていうのはですね、当時のことを今調べましたら、私の書いた8月11日の記事、これは全く韓国でも報道されてませんでした。
But also, I'd like to explain some of the research that I've been doing to try to clear my name. I mentioned that I wrote this article first about this woman who had come forward. Her name was Kim, Miss Kim, and I wrote an article on August 11th in 1991. I tried to find out if this article had been picked up by the South Korean media at all, and none of them picked up on it.
このため私は反日機運が煽ったと言われてもですね、煽ってません。
In other words, this accusation that somehow my article or that I have incited anti-Japanese sentiments is completely erroneous.
むしろ日本がアジアの中で本当に信頼される仲間になるための作業をしていると思ってます。
In other words, what I think that I am doing is not something to try to encourage anti-Japanese sentiments, but I'm doing exactly the opposite. I am trying my very best to do a work which will allow Japan to become a nation that can be considered a trusted partner by neighboring Asian countries.
Well, thank you very much. I'm afraid we're out of time. I want to thank Uemura-san in particular for coming here today for what I know was a very difficult personal decision and one in which, believe it or not, he had to consider even his safety. So if you could show your appreciation for him, that would be much appreciated. Thank you. Just a couple, again, of reminders. Can I ask you to stay seated until all the speakers have left the room, please? Thank you. That's just to avoid confusion at the end. And also, can I remind you that we have written a letter of condolence to the French Embassy, which we will deliver tonight. You can sign it at the door on your way out. We'd like as many as possible to sign that if you'd be kind enough. Thank you very much for coming today, and thank you for your attention.